Hi, and welcome to this video where we're going to go through how to calculate the lease liability at initial recognition. Before getting into the calculation, I thought I'd just let you know that what we're going to cover here is applicable for all the standards and even the classification operating finance if you're under ASC 842. The reason for that is the present value methodology is the same at the commencement of the lease because you are present valuing the known future lease payments at that point in time. So if you want to calculate your lease liability at the start, you come to the right place. Now, basically the start is what they all have in common and then they diverge. So even if you're doing a finance or operating lease under ASC 842, you want to move on to your right of use asset, that differs. And then IFRS 16, so on and so forth, especially once you start hitting modification accounting, things like decrease in scope, all that fun stuff, it all diverges, but this is a great place to start. It's a good building block and you will get a very accurate lease liability amount at commencement and then you can go on from there. The next thing about this calculation is we're doing a daily calculation and not a monthly. And on that note, let's start and let's calculate this lease liability. So here are our lease details and we have the inputs required to do a lease liability. We have our commencement, our accounting end date, our payments. We're going to be paying $1,000. We're going to be paying in advance as opposed to in arrears. We're going to be paying monthly and we're going to apply a discount rate of 7% to these payments, which will get our lease liability amount. And as I mentioned, we're doing a daily calculation. So there's our daily discount rate to calculate the daily interest on the lease liability. So let's get into it. So first things first, I am going to add the dates of the lease agreement. Now, why I'm doing this, you might, why are you doing it? Daily, isn't this overkill? Well, I would definitely say no, not overkill. Because when you have modification accounting, it happens mid-month. Well, what do you do when you're doing a monthly calculation? When you have a payment, an ad hoc payment, let's say on the 8th, How do you account for that when you're using a monthly calculation? Well, essentially you really can't, or you sort of can, and it doesn't work as well. And it's a bit like putting a square peg in a round hole. Not really worth it, especially when, as we're going here, it's not that much of a time investment. So what I'm up to next, so I've added the dates. Now we're adding the payments. So that occur, those $1,000 payments. Now we're going to be applying an XMPB formula. Now for the XMPB formula to work in Excel, it requires a no blank cells. So we're going to fill those blank cells with zeros. Simple enough, within Excel, we select our blanks, we hit OK. Give it a little time to think. And then once we input the zeros, we now have enough information to calculate our opening balance of the lease liability. So that's what we're going to do. So as I mentioned, we're going to use, out of all the functions in Excel to calculate the present value, we'll use that XMPV. We'll apply our discount rate. We'll then select our values, which is our lease payments. And then the next thing is we will select the dates, and that takes into consideration the dates of the payment. There we have our lease liability at commencement of the lease. Just quickly, if you were to use a NPV, you'll see we have our rate and then our payments, our values. There's no date. And that what that will then do is the NPV will assume that all the payments are based on the same amount of time, which in the lease accounting world doesn't always happen. So you want that XMPB for that additional accuracy. Now let's finish off this calculation. So first thing is we have our lease liability post-payment. Very simple there. Now let's calculate our daily interest, which is the lease liability post-payment, times that daily discount rate here. And then we have our lease liability closing amount. And we have completed the first row. All we need to do now is copy and paste these formulas down. But to do that, we would need to fix some of the cells so all the formulas work. So let's get into that. Oopsie, press the wrong button. And now let's fix the rows. the end rows because they're not going anywhere. And then let's fix that discount rate. They may go somewhere if you have a modification. This doesn't need to be fixed. Again, this does. We're always going to use that daily discount unless there's been a modification. And that's, so now we're good to copy and paste everything down. Let's start with the lease liability. And we put that in. So now we have the lease liability prepayment for every day. Perfect. And now let's follow suit with these last inputs. And then voila, we have the lease liability and it goes to zero, which is the ultimate test on the last day when you have that obligation of the payment. And we have calculated the lease liability. Now you may think that's pretty simple and quick and easy, but like I mentioned at the start, this is the first building block. You've now got your right of use asset. You now need to revisit this calculation every month to do your journals to unwind that lease liability, so on and so forth with the right of use asset. We haven't touched on modification accounting. So when the lessor comes to you and does a, say, CPI or market rent review, how that's accounted for, how to remeasure the lease liability and the right of use asset. What's a decrease in scope, how to account for that and that P&L gain loss that will occur on a decrease in the scope. As you're seeing, there's it's a bit of a wormhole and a rabbit hole to calculate for this lease accounting standard. So here's the quick pitch. If you want all of this done instantly, starting with your calculations, then your financial reports, then your disclosures for either two or three leases or 2,000 leases, have a look at Cradle's lease accounting software. We automate everything. It saves a huge amount of time for you. You can focus on other things. You can probably keep your sanity, and I think everybody wins. But any questions on the calculation, leave some comments below in the video. If you want this actual calculation, reach out to contact@cradleaccounting.com and we'll flick that through. And if you have any particular videos you'd like to see, of course, we'd be more happy, relating to lease accounting, we'd be more than happy to provide some content if it's of value to you, especially if you want to do it manually. You've got a long road ahead, and this is the first place to start. So thank you for your time.